Hi folks, welcome to this short demo on Test Data Manager or our product on synthetic data generation. There are a lot of use cases for this particular product that we have within the DataOps suite. It ranges from masking data or having synthetic data generated for stress testing ETL pipelines or other tool sets. And there's also the aspect of creating test data itself so that we can use production grade data in our test cases. So a lot of different test cases that we create with this, and a couple of things before we jump into the actual short showcase itself. Firstly, the application is Spark based. That implies that we can work inherently with a lot of different type of data sources. And related to this particular point is the fact that the application can be installed directly onto your infrastructure as well, be it an AWS-based system, Google Cloud-based system, or Azure-based system, all integrated with scaling services like auto-scaling, Kubernetes, Databricks, and so on. Now, let's assume that you want to create production-grade data. So you define your connections to any of these, as you can see. There's a lot of nuance here as well with regards to integrations with your credential management service and other systems. But once you have defined your connection, we move into the test data manager. So I'm going to go ahead and use an existing example to save time here, where, as you can see, a few tables have already been imported. The import process is very straightforward. Just define exactly what tables you would like to go ahead with. And within the import, the application is going to do a lot of things at once. It's going to understand what the primary keys of the tables are, primary and foreign keys, to understand the relationship between tables, as this is an important relation that has to be maintained within the synthetic data as well. And along with that, if you look at this demographic specific data, dim customer, it's also going to try to find out PII entities inherently. The reason for this is going to come in handy shortly, but the main gist here is that the application does a first pass of finding out any PII entities. And if you would like to, you can define something as a PII entity as well. For a particular reason, if I want to say skip this particular total children out, I can define that as an entity and work it and associate that with the corresponding entity as defined here. So a lot of specific use cases present here. And the main reason we are masking this data here is that the next step within the process is to fetch a bit of sample records. These sample records, as you can see on your screen, are already masked with regards to the configuration that we have done just one screen earlier. And what we're going to do is use this sample and plug it into a machine learning based generation tool, which is based on machine learning. And in the upcoming model, it's also generative AI based to understand the correlations between the data sets. So what I mean by this is that in this particular demographics data set, you see that we have an age flag and, you know, birth date flag, which can be simply considered as an age flag. And along with that, we also have a flag for married. Now, there's going to be an easy correlation defined that only if you're above 18, you're going to be most likely married. So that particular flag definition is based on a correlation on date or age. These sort of correlations are inherently picked up by the application. You don't have to define them within the system. It's not just that, it's also kind of can go ahead and if you would like to define correlations on the data sets that you're working with. An easy example here is that if the sample records you're working with are inherently female, if you would like to, you can actually define that the synthetic data also pertains to that kind of skewness. Of course, if you do not want to go ahead, the application can pick up records at random and do this inherently, but again, you have a lot of control there. And before the actual generation, the application is going to give you the exact specifics of what it has understood is going on here. So it has understood that the customer key is actually a foreign key. So we need to make sure that it references another table. It has defined geography key as an integer. And if I want to define geography key as a very specific domain, say I want to ensure that this is an integer and it's always between 0 and 100 because I have just those many geography keys present, I can define them as well. This goes into line with any kind of expected skews that you might want to put in within the data set as well. So if I'm aware that, okay, that the geography keys I'm working with are between 0 and 100 only, but I want to see how the application is going to react if there is 101 and 105 within this as well. So you can actually put it within the definitions of the synthetic data as well. It's not just numeric systems. As you can see, we have a lot of use cases here where you can define domains, categories, inherent fake data itself, which comes from a good amount of providers. So we have good libraries here and you can customize these to a great degree. And apart from that, if you really like to, you can just type out a proper Python code itself within the system. So that way you can actually have complete control over what type of synthetic data you're working with. Very helpful if you're working with synthetic data where the correlation is very obvious and you want to work with proper sums itself. So if column A plus column B equals column C, that's something you can define in here as well. Of course, all of this is optional. In most cases, you should be good to go with specifics that you have the application has picked up. And once you've done this, the application has done all of this for all the tables inherently. The next step to do is just to generate them. So let's open up an existing data set. Let's open up this one right there. It's going to ask us where we want to push this particular synthetic data and how do we want to push it. So of course, depending on your use case, this might be a file, this might be a database. And according to your use case specifically, like say, let's say instead of an S3 location, let's actually push them back to SQL Server. So the application is first going to ask which all data sets you would like to define as synthetic and then how many records you would like to run across them. And once you've done that, the final steps are quite straightforward. It's going to ask you to push these records, either append them or if you would like to overwrite existing records or other aspects, you get all those options with files as well as with databases. I'm not doing that for the interest of time. And of course, the final aspect here is that if you want to say define them as on a schedule or if you want to associate them with an existing pipeline, at the moment new fresh production level data comes in, you want to make sure that the testing data is in sync with that level. You can do that in an automated fashion integrated with your existing pipelines. Or if you're doing this on a schedule based system, which is different from your existing CI/CD pipelines or DevOps systems, you can define that as well. There's a lot of integrations and other aspects that I'm not really getting into in the interest of time, but this in a nutshell defines what Test Data Manager is. For any more questions, feel free to contact us at datagaps.com.